The most exciting add-on for the Raspberry Pi 5 has finally arrived. This is the NVME HatDrive from Pineberry Pi. Here we have the Pineberry Pi HatDrive in the original package. Let's open it up. It's a very simple packaging. Inside we have three plastic bags, some spacers and some screws. This seems to be a GPIO adapter, and this is the head drive board. The data cable is already connected, so without wasting any more time, let's see how we can connect it to our Pi. This is a top drive, so it will sit above the Raspberry Pi, something like this, and the cable will be connected in this PCI Express connector. So let's see how this will sit. Let's take some spacers first. I'm gonna take a small NVMe drive. In order to flash this drive, you're gonna need some sort of an adapter. I use this IC box NVMe adapter in order to write the required image on the drive itself. So this is a mounting screw, it's the smallest one, and another spacer. Let's try to connect it up. Spacer should sit in this bezel, small bezel. Okay, let's check out these extenders. Now we should pull on this little tab and connect the data cable, make sure it's pulled all the way. Now I should be able to screw everything back in. It seems that I have an extra screw. For the GPIO extender, I'm not going to use it, so I have no reason to install it. All you have to do is plug it in over here. The pins will go through the board and you'll be able to access them on top. But since I'm not using any GPIO function, I don't need this right now. I'm going to use it later on if required. At this moment, the Pi will still boot from the SD drive. In order to switch the boot to the NVMe, we need to do a few settings in the firmware and small adjustments to the NVMe speed in order to benefit from the entire bandwidth for the drive that we just installed. So we have just a few more steps left. First of all, I want to show you that indeed the NVMe drive is detected, even if we're booting from the SD card right now. I already have an OS installed on the NVMe, so that's why you can see multiple partitions over here. In order to enable booting from NVMe, we need to do some small changes. In my case, we have to run this command in order to edit the EEPROM so we can boot from the NVMe drive. You can find online that we have the recommendation to add here number 6. Number 6 will tell the system to boot from NVMe first. But I want to change it a little bit. In my case, I want the system to boot first from the SD card, then from the NVMe and USB if it's not available. All I have to do in order to change that, I'm gonna delete the 1. 1 is the SD card. I'm gonna leave 6 and put the 1 behind it. If I save it like that, the system will try to boot from the SD card, then NVMe, then USB mass storage device. I did this because if, for example, something happens to the NVMe drive and I want to do a quick boot in another operating system, I can simply plug in the SD card, the system will boot from it, I can do whatever changes I want without removing the NVMe drive, save it, and then just remove the card. If we look a little bit further in the documentation, Pineberry recommends that we add PCIE probe equals 1. Now, in order to save the file, we just need to press Ctrl O, Ctrl X, exit, and now we should just use a sudo reboot. We are back, the operating system booted without issues from the SD card. Another small but important change that we can do is to increase the PCIe Express speed by using the Gen 3 parameter. We have to nano slash boot slash config.txt. And right here, I want to add this value. DT parameter PCI Express speed to Gen 3. Control O, my bad. Control X, don't save modified changes. This should be a sudo. Now I can paste it. DT parameter. Now we should be fine. Exit. You can shut down the Raspberry Pi, remove the SD card, and you will be able to boot from the NVMe drive. Please remember that this last command in the boot configuration, I'm gonna run it again. This line that I have added right here, in my case, it's only added to the SD card since I booted from the SD card. You have to do this operation again once the NVMe boot is enabled. That's it for this short tutorial. I hope you found it useful. If so, please don't forget to like and subscribe.